So we've recently explored the misuse of AI technology and its impact that it has on all of us in the creative industries. If you've missed it, we've put a link in the description. Today, the dangers of voice cloning are more present than ever. Your voice could be used to scam your loved ones or stolen and used without your consent. So the problem's clear, but what's the solution? In this video, we'll take a look at some of the practical steps you can take right now to reduce the risk of cloning.
Hey, this calls for strategy. I'll fight fire with fire.
So how does voice cloning work? Well, right now, the most well-known voice cloning apps are 11labs and play.ht. You might have heard of others like Murph, Resemble, Revoicer, Respeecher, and so on. There are loads of them, and they are all much of a muchness. To clone someone's voice using these apps, a user needs to create an account and then upload 3 hours of recorded speech to train the algorithm. It's that easy. You can even create a clone with less audio, but it won't sound as convincing. And most of the apps recommend 10 to 25 hours of speech for the most believable sounding quality. Getting that quantity of speech from your average person is difficult, but if you already share a substantial amount of audio or video content online, preventing theft and cloning is near impossible. Politicians, YouTubers, and even audiobook narrators are all vulnerable. When it comes to paid voiceover or acting work, the first step to protecting yourself is prevention. There are several ways to do this, one of which is don't record anything without a written contract. It's always important to have a written record of your work and to have a contract or release form for every gig. Knowing where you've allowed your voice to be used is critical because it'll help identify any unauthorized usage of your voice.
That wasn't a bit nice. You have made me very angry. Very angry indeed.
For actors, presenters, or narrators, every project you record should include a release form or work order stating who you are granting publishing rights to, what are the limitations specifying platforms and territories, and when and for how long you are granting the use of the material. If the client doesn't have a talent release form, purchase order, or contract detailing this information, ask them to provide you one or provide your own. Do not take the job without a written release document signed by both parties. Also, if there's no clause about AI in the release form prohibiting the creation of AI voices or clones with the material you provided, make sure it's added.
Make records.
While it may not prevent the issue, it can give you an immediate recourse to prove theft or unauthorized use, so you can seek legal advice should anyone clone your voice without consent or use it for something you didn't agree to. However, it's not just contracts you should be reading cover to cover. Don't forget about the terms of service. As a performer, knowing what you are signing up for is vital to protecting your data from being used without your consent. It sounds pretty straightforward, but in a study conducted by Michigan State University and the University of Connecticut, 98% of people spend less than 5 minutes reading the terms of service. Be mindful that whenever you tick the I agree box, you may be granting a license to the platform to use your content for training AIs, resale, or even promotional purposes. Platforms that try to sneak AI training permissions into their terms of service need to be held accountable. And if you see something that you don't like, make some noise about it. So the terms of service are a great resource for revealing how safe and secure a platform is. But what other factors make a casting platform secure? Even if the platform's terms of service seem fair, their poorly built architecture may inadvertently enable theft. For example, can users quickly access and download your audio files without your knowledge? If that's a yes, be super careful.
I am more muscular, more cunning, faster, and larger than you are, and I'm a genius.
Many casting platforms enable demo downloads by default. This is a huge mistake and puts all your audio files at risk. You should always know who is downloading your demos and why. If a platform allows users to do this without controls or moderation, complain. A casting director should only need 1 or 2 files for approval. If they request your entire back catalog, be suspicious.
Scram, Sherlock. I'm working this side of the street.
When you send demos or auditions to clients, we recommend watermarking your audio. There's no way of knowing where your demos or auditions could end up, so it's still vital to watermark your files before submitting them for casting.
Using audio watermarks every 3 to 5 seconds will allow you to put your voice out into the world and not have to worry about it being stolen or misused.
This is my audio.
AI training models love clean audio, so always include a background soundtrack in audio submissions. If the platform allows, you can also have a name slate. Watermarking is like installing spotlights outside your home. A burglar could still get in, but they are less likely to try to rob you when the next house over looks like an easier mark. For actors submitting self-taped auditions, partially hiding your face with your hair or a scarf is recommended to prevent the creation of deepfakes of your visual likeness. Always make note of when and where you submit auditions. Being organized will help you identify the origin of any unauthorized use. Watermarking isn't the only way to outsmart AI clones, so let's talk about duration and quality. AI cloning algorithms need lots of data, so if you keep your online exposure short, the chances of you being cloned are reduced. Submitting shorter samples of your work instead of full-length recordings is a practical step every performer should take. The other thing you can do is lower the audio or video quality or bitrate.
Yes, very curious, very interesting.
Thieves always want the highest quality to create their voice clones. Most of the apps will struggle without clean, high-definition audio. So always use MP3 instead of WAV for everything, except the final delivery. Lowering the bit and sample rate a notch will put off the thieves, but still be sufficient to demonstrate your vocal ability. So right now, our best shot is to make our demos and reels as unappealing to thieves as possible, whilst not putting off legitimate customers. That's definitely a challenge. Technology is likely to help us protect our voices in the future, but for now, ensuring the use of contracts, reading the terms of service, using secure platforms, watermarking auditions, and keeping the total audio out in the public to a minimum will help to deter criminals from cloning you when there are easier targets. This doesn't mean any of us should be satisfied with the current situation, though. The AI voiceover and cloning apps need to do more to prevent unauthorized and unethical cloning, because it's clear that the laws and regulations need to catch up fast. So let's keep the pressure on. See ya.